Hello, Year 7, and welcome back to your geography lessons. We really hope you've had a restful half term and are looking forward to starting your new unit of work on impossible places. So, this term is slightly different in what we're asking you to submit. We are going to set a number of tasks throughout the lesson that we would like you to complete, but we're asking for you to submit only one of the tasks. And as you can see here, that task is highlighted in yellow. So today we would like you to complete all of the tasks, but to make it a little bit more simple for you, we would like you to submit only the extended writing at the end. So it's really important you work through the lesson, you complete all of the other tasks because they are going to help you lead up to that final task on why is Norway an impossible place to live. So we, as I've already mentioned, we are going to be studying impossible places this half term. So every week you'll be studying a different place or different country that it poses challenges for the people that live there. So to start, I would like you to start thinking about what an impossible place is. So list all of the words you would associate with impossible places. Maybe you might think they will be too hot or too cold, or too mountainous, or too close to the sea, so maybe at risk of flooding. So what places do you think might be really difficult for people to live in? Think of everything you know about geography already. Think of all of the different natural features that you've studied in geography lessons as well, and try and think about as many different words that you could associate with living in an impossible place. And as you can see, this week we're going to start with Norway. So we're going to be looking at impossible Norway. So what I'd also now like you to do, once you've got all of your words, try and join these words or some of these words together to create a definition for what you think impossible places are. So you might start this by saying, impossible places are places that or places which, and you can then finish that sentence yourself. So if you were trying to describe what you think an impossible place is to somebody, what would you say? There's no right or wrong answer here. There's no official definition. This is just something for you to think about. So you can pause the video here. You can have a go at these tasks if you haven't started already. And then once you've finished, you can start the video again. So, what we would like you to do is think about why Norway is an impossible place. So, there are a couple of YouTube clips, and these are linked in the YouTube comment section for this lesson as well, but they're also available on Satchel 1 and in the PowerPoint itself. So, lots of different ways that you can access the YouTube clips here. So I'd like you to either click on the title link in the PowerPoint, or you can click on the link that is attached in the comment section on Satchel 1 or YouTube. I'd like you to think about all of the different factors that might make Norway a difficult place to live. And this is just a bit of a starter to get you to understand what Norway is like as a country, maybe what it looks like, the climate, and all of the other things that might make it quite difficult for people to live there. Today, I'm hoping that you'll be able to describe the location of Norway and also describe and explain the difficulties of the Arctic environment on humans. So that gives you a bit of a clue as to where Norway is. So here are some links as well. So if you want to really push yourself in this lesson, you might use some of these links to help you to further your understanding and research of Norway. So you can click on the links. Again, they're in Satchel 1, they're in the PowerPoint, and they will take you to some different fact files and different video clips that will tell you a little bit about Norway. So this is a bit of an extra challenge if you still think you'd like to learn more about Norway. So the first task today, just a reminder, you don't have to submit this to your teacher, but you are more than welcome to submit it to your teacher if you'd like feedback, is to describe the location of Norway. So if you can see on these maps, you've got a more zoomed in version on the left, which shows Norway, which borders Sweden. And then you've got Norway shown as well on the map of Europe. So it's towards the top by the line that says Arctic Circle, 66 degrees north. So where is Norway? So what I'd like you to do is describe where Norway is. You're probably going to need to think about where Norway is in terms of Europe. So is it in the northern parts of Europe? Okay, is it north of the UK? Is it close to the Arctic Circle? What oceans surround it? So we've got the Atlantic Ocean and the Norwegian Sea, and also the Arctic Ocean right at the top. So think about making sure when you're describing location, you name some of the seas or oceans that it's near, but you also name some of the bordering countries as well, and use compass points like north, south, east and west. So hopefully you know here that Europe, we know, is in the northern hemisphere. So Norway is one of the most northerly countries in the northern hemisphere, especially one of the most northerly countries in Europe itself. So have a go at describing the location of Norway using all of this information. And then I'd like you to think about, what about Norway's location suggests it is an impossible place to live? Obviously, the north of the country is particularly impossible. And just to give you a bit of a clue, the Arctic Ocean is usually completely frozen in winter months. So think about how cold that must make Norway. So again, pause here, have a go at answering these questions. You can use the internet if you have that available to you in order to do a little bit more research on Norway's location if you would like. So your second task is looking at Norway's climate. So here you have something called a climate graph, and it's really important that you understand how to read a climate graph. So on a climate graph, it shows two things. It shows the rainfall as a bar chart, and it shows the temperature as a line graph. So have a look here and make sure you can clearly see the bar charts and also the line graph that is being displayed. At the bottom, you'll see that it shows the months of the year. So it goes through from January, February, March, all the way through to December. So what this graph is showing us is the rainfall for every month of the year, but also the temperature. And we have to be really careful here that we read off the correct axes for rainfall and temperature. So rainfall is shown on the left-hand side in millimetres, and temperature is shown on the right-hand side in degrees centigrade. So what you can see is that the rainfall is quite high throughout the year, and sometimes that rainfall might be actually snow, so it might be snowfall rather than rainfall at times. But also we can see that the maximum temperature in their summer months, which is when their hottest weather would be, only gets to around 15 degrees. Now currently it is, so the weekend just gone, okay, we've just experienced around 16 degrees centigrade in London. So that gives you an idea of just how that temperature is slightly different to where we live. So if the hottest it gets is around the temperatures we're experiencing in January, that is quite a big difference. So what you'll see in the winter months, it is often around -5, but also it can get lower than -5 and edging towards -10 degrees. So we're talking very, very cold weather for many months of the year. So what I'd like you to do here is use all of the different words and figures from the word box to complete this word fill on Oslo's climate. So Oslo is the capital here of Norway. So I'd like you please to complete this word fill, write it out, or you can kind of drag the words from the word box into the correct places on the PowerPoint. But I'd like you to write this out and fill in any of the gaps. As always, there's a little challenge. Okay, it says, can you work out the temperature and rainfall range for Oslo, or the annual rainfall? So annual means yearly. So what's the yearly rainfall? How would we work out the yearly rainfall? What would we have to do to those bars of rain for each month? And also the temperature range, remember, is taking the lowest temperature away from the highest temperature. So make sure you have a little go at that if you can. So the third task, and this is going to help you with the task that you have to submit, is to complete the mind map with your own ideas of how Norway's climate, so how much rain it has and how cold it gets, how that is going to impact people in Norway, the jobs that people do, the environment and the habitats and the animals that live there, and also any maybe laws that might be put in place. Again, there's not necessarily right and wrong answers for this, but I'd like you to divide up any impacts you can think of into those categories: social, which are impacts of on people and the way that they live their lives. Economic will be impacts on the jobs that people do. So here I've got a picture of a ski instructor. Is that a job that we would have in this country, a ski instructor? Probably not. So maybe what other jobs can you think of that people might do in Norway that we wouldn't do here? Also, think about the way in which people live their lives. Think about maybe the sports that people will do in Norway at school. So for example, children in Norway will have ski lessons during their PE lessons. Now again, that's a social thing that's impacting people. It might also impact the way we dress. It might impact the way that we build our buildings. So really have a think about that. And also, can you think of any animals that you know of that live in the Arctic? So here we've got a picture of a snow leopard. How might the snow leopard have adapted to living in this climate? What about polar bears as well? So they will be found in the northern parts of Norway too. So I'd like you to think of as many different impacts that the climate might have on Norway. And that then all leads us to your piece of work that you will submit to your teacher that will be marked. So your final task and the task that you're going to submit this week is an extended piece of writing that says that will answer the question, why is Norway an impossible place to live? So I want you to gather all of the information that you've used today, any additional research that you've carried out, and I'd like you to answer this question. You can divide your impacts into obviously SEEP, which is our social, economic, environmental and political impacts. Also, maybe long-term and short-term impacts of the climate. For example, a short-term impact might be just the way that somebody dresses on a cold day, or it might be the fact that a school has to be closed because of the snow. A long-term impact on climate might be the jobs that people do. So you can think about that, but also you could include positive and negatives. Maybe you don't think Norway is an impossible place to live, and that's absolutely fine. There's a few sentence starters here that will help you. It says Norway might be considered an impossible environment. This is because maybe you'll refer to the climate. Maybe you'll refer to the map that we've studied. Maybe you'll refer to some of the impacts you've come up with already. Okay, but I will stress lots of people live in Norway, so obviously there are lots of people that don't think it's an impossible place to live. So this is the task that we're really, really focused on, and we would really like you to submit this task specifically to your teacher. If you'd like to submit everything, that is absolutely fine, but there is no expectation for you to submit every single task. There is the expectation that you submit this one. And then finally, there's always a challenge. If you get through the lesson quickly, you can mind map some ideas for how people could overcome the impossibilities in Norway. What solutions do you think people will come up with in order to help them live there? So just to recap, these are the tasks that we would like you to complete. And a reminder that the task at the bottom there in yellow is the task that we would like you to submit to your teacher this week. I hope that will make sense. As always, you will have your drop-in sessions with your teachers this week. You can email your teachers if you have any questions at all. and we look forward to reading some of your amazing work.